Iqaluit, good morning. Today is January 11, 2022. Thank you for tuning in. My name is Seema Saharzerhi. I'm Premier Akeeagok's press secretary. Premier Akeeagok will start by providing an overview of the COVID-19 numbers and situation in the territory. Minister Main will speak on our current healthcare capabilities, and Minister Gross will provide us an update on the state of our education system and our plans for resuming education around the territory. And then Dr. Patterson will provide us an update on the Omicron variant and COVID-19 health situation. We're going to be open for question afterwards. One question, one follow-up, please. And thank you.
Luta Patterson, who also has it, Omicron, Nova Jono, Mitsano, a person in Takui.
Yeah, Dakoyaname, Ule, Dakopaka, Nunavumutin, Pidong Watamina Kulupun, Udrango Yok Nalatun, Udrango Yok Nalonero Nasivunga, 192 Nuva Nodzuan, Hatun, Nunavun Iduane, Manoyo, 13 Muyu, Nunalivun, Atoktosimayun. 21 ngovon akvianen, 16 ngovon ikalutu tianen, 4 ngovon idluligadunen, 2 idlulimen, 55 tavan ikalunen, 22 ngovon kinganen, 8 panotumen, 1 mitimatalumen, 4 kikatadruamen, 35 kangitlinumen, 1 Sanikiduamen, 8 Sanagayamen, and 7 Tikiradjuanen. Kulagukan, Udlanguyum, Taludjuanen, Nalunatosimajokalapo, Nuvanadjuahatum. Udlanguyum, 26 Muvun, Nuvanadjuaharun Nilsimajo, Nunavumutain. Katilimatu Widakua, 165 Mulupo, Nuvanadjuaharun Nilsimajo, Nunavun. Iluan itu adalah nuwan nazar pergi alam semata dengan itu sangat tumit nidia guna kamu berang yang kubah setiap pengai dan pelajar waktu minta aku kapok tahu semaju nuna bumiutain udlumi mutik itu 89% move nuna bumiutain 5 nih kurangan akagulin kapok tahu semaju sibuk terpamen aku 71% move tunggu dia gun kapok tau si maju makwakte. Takwa 39% palo buta nuna bumiutain 18 in akagulin kurano. Takwa pingajuan in kapok tau si maju udlumi mutikit lewin. Ikaiti tikan na rumabunga takwa kapok tau gunatu nuna bumiutai kapok tau katalin. Takwa kitong wakulu buta kapok tau gunarute uluana jekute migut jawa matakwa kapok tau katasi majum. Pergi aku tu kau kan nero mabungai dia ipasya sivulot terjua Prime Minister Trudeau amma sivulotin kana talimami kati makati kikun nalau kaki ipasya tu sah vigi dutigo nidia vigi dutigo dlo kano tana nuvan nazuak atu iwa dia simalingi kalwa mangan kana talimami nalun aku nidia lopu unikata uwa dia tijuin takwa kana talimami kano tigi tana nuvan nazuak atu isimangi kalwa mangan. Takwa pidoang waktu me ania surti kuluvun kawi sakto juavun amma takwa ikana yati tu sao mati tijigi kato tevun atuk tau si mati juapun amisun nalun akun ne jaupu kana tali mamen takwa lu ania vin kadluna nunangan i twitteum amisu ku padlian lu tu takwa nuvan na juan tata padlian ingin uluwan atu miti tisimajun ipin non nalauivun. Nalunekan nerun nalaupunga ipasa ukala tijuta katima tijuta takwa nunavun tusirar katasi majangin amma pimmari ugisi majavu maana mutikitsegu. Takwa nalunerun nakan nepuguja gavamatukakunnen hujan namitiapugun Iqaluit simalum matamana mutikitli go pidiwanguatu mitako a kawi sakta kotigi gunnatte nuvan nuzwata hangikalwa mangan. Tako kiinamun matuan tusirasimajavun. Amatako idlumun kieti jekutingin ipidiwanguatu me ilinjavikulutinun tusiragila watikutta. Tako pidiwanguatu watliasimaningin gavamatukakunin nalunerunasim kanopunga utangoju. Takwatau kanatali maami attuktausi mammi juhualuan luuttaakuluin aania siutikuluvun amma takwa kawi sattotuavun amigannittin nalunneikan nerun nalummivunga takwa udlumimun attukpadliasima jättikun amma taanna iddukissannuppun assualu attuisimaninga nalunneikan nerun nalupaga kawijumagatta siagmapadliasimamman nunalitta ilanginni Iddukissanne pidjutikiddutikun. Tamanna nirupunga iddukissanne pun kanuttuuriaka kautikinnitta maanna kautika amma sivunimun panna padlianiattiluta uluguenattumirunnatikun nunavummiutain. Pinna suarusi ulottu udlutuinnautitiku January 7 utitiku nalunneikannerunnarivunga taakkoa kauisattu kautikikunnattu nuvannuk hankikaluamangatta. Takwa mitarvinun Winnipeg men, Edmonton men, Ottawa men, Sanikiluang men, Iqalunne, Kangitlinun men, amma Yellowknife men, nasiutikun naksimalagattikun maannaujum. Takwa kaujumagatta kaujisakautikikijaukunnattu nuvannatuakhan kalwamangata siagmakpadliakunnatikun nunalittinun atuutikadlattaammata udlumimutikitlikun. Nunavummiutai nalunneikannerumagivunga taakkoa sivulluttiukatikka ministeriuti gavamakkunnin tavvani katakatikikunnalaukakki pinnasuaru siulluttuun. Taakkoa kannon avittorsimajun gavamakkunniittiun kannu nunavummiutan ikajurunnangi kaluamangata. Nalunneikannerumatiapunga taakkoa nunavummiutanun taakkoa tusannidlaridauttuun ministeriutiin isumassaksiurutin tunnisijaumata. Nirupiapunga taakkoa pinnasuarussirin jättättinne ilengin sakripadliagu maniagattikun taanna tusattitikun nasikutta tusattitikautikin jättukun nirukujitlinga taasik taakkunningam. Pijarirpadlialunga taakkoa nunavummiutai tiliurtuikannerumavunga taakkoa angiqarsimagunnattu angiqarsimainnarlin pulaagajagattangillutun illumiukatikin ittaminnum kapurtaugunnattu kapurtaulin. Kiinnammu matuarsimainnariakakattam. Amma taakkoa nuvannatuakakasukukussi ukaalakattarlusi taakkoa naaseutti teijaukattarsimajunnun. Taakkoa nunalivun seilmakunnatikun taakkunninga nuvannatuannin assukuakakpadlianginnanniakatteilään. Se on kujannamiin. Udlakun, udlakun to nunavumiu that are listening, especially to our elders. As of this morning, Nunavut has 192 positive cases of COVID-19. We have active cases in 13 communities right now, 21 in Akvian, 16 in Cambridge Bay, 4 in Chesterfield Inlet, 2 in Iqaluit, 55 in Iqaluit, 22 in Kingane, 8 in Pandoktu, 1 in Pond Inlet, 4 in Khikirtarzua, 35 in Rankin Inlet, 1 in Sanikilua, 8 in Sanirayak, and 7 in Whale Cove. In addition, there is one presumptive case in Sanikilua, in Talurjua, my apologies. There are 26 recoveries today. There have been 165 total recoveries in this outbreak. On a positive note, I am pleased to announce that many of you are rolling up your sleeves to get vaccinated. Today, 89% of Nunavummiut 5 years and older have received their first dose, 71% have received their second dose. Approximately 39% of Nunavummiut over the age of 18 have received their booster shots. I hope that every one of you rolls up your sleeves and get vaccinated. and please get your kids vaccinated as well. Yesterday, I attended a First Minister's meeting chaired by Prime Minister Trudeau on the COVID-19 status in Canada. It's clear from reports from premiers across the country that we are in a critical situation. Resources such as nurses, lab capacity, and healthcare staff are limited right across this country. Many hospitals in the south are already overwhelmed with positive cases. I took the opportunity at this meeting to restate our urgent healthcare needs. The federal government has already stepped up to provide rapid test kits, N95 masks, and support for improving ventilation in our schools. However, I noted that Nunavut continues to need help on the human resource front, especially nurses and lab technicians. I also stressed the need to address our housing gap. Overcrowding is severely impacting the spread of COVID-19 in our communities. Nunavut needs immediate action on housing to provide our residents homes to safely isolate in. As of Friday, January 7, we have started to distribute take-home rapid test kits to airports in Winnipeg, Edmonton, Ottawa, San Nikilua, Iqaluit, Rankin Inlet, as well as Yellowknife. These rapid test kits will provide another tool for managing the outbreaks in our communities. Last week, I held an urgent meeting with members of my cabinet to discuss each department's plans for rolling out emergency COVID-19 initiatives. I want to ensure that Nunavummiut receive the supports needed to weather this outbreak. I was very pleased with the innovative plans presented by ministers and look forward to announcing some of these initiatives very soon. Please continue to do your part to keep Nunavut safe from Omicron. Please stay home, get vaccinated, and get your booster shot, wear a mask, alert the COVID hotline, and isolate if you have any symptoms. We all need to do our part to keep our communities safe. Puyanname.
Blacher. He would look pamic, Nelnea Hortunga, Awek, in no he being at a mechanic. Akwini di Pilareu, you take any, Nelnea after him a little sugit, Nuang Narakang after the sugit. Man, now you make Inutokangnik, take an ermuto unique, Awek, Akto Hibianic, at Toto, him a yok to young it took, Nelnea after him a yok. Amalu ing migut oya loket taktu luartunik pilareinut ikayortawin na khawduti hanat tele ago he makko kang khimayut taku blugit matna lunga khoyan na mer lunga koana lalunga lu kihianiu yu yakmat nunabummi atna tele ditchinam pilareiu yunut pilare himar jwa rapi nalunang itok A corn after Nidlu, a doctor came to him. He hear any overgood, Upigo hook to look down, woogood, illipidney. Nayang wait, and yes, you did, a malu, how you hack to the renal mobility you yut. Happily low came on in Sutik, Pilarin now yak him a yut. No one now you are Lerenio Mikanut, Nanny, no one now you are Takale Mangat. Kanoglu, Nelune, Yakap Mangapta, Nathalit, Chico, Bluta, amalu kinguk mu tu yakhlutik nuwang naluakak tuwinik kitunik kanigiya kalau mangata kawi halok yakhlutik amalu taw anate editikut pilereyigi miyangit ahit ikayong nakaluak himagibut tamatuma nuwang naluakalenyo mikanut tamna pidyutigitsugu nuwang naluak omicron ngunaktaw yok Nunaling mik, nunaling kanang mut, outlak pad leninga, amalu nuwang naluali, amihung pad leningit, pidutigit suit, at neatelit chiku bluta, a hang of the regarak himabut, aula nereyaptitnik. Ikayutik kanang nik, hake himayugut, amalu akega kemasuta, pilreniu hoktunik. Nunaring mihung itu galuit, pilereyit, okaleutikut, ikayok tatu luatut, atuin no oktilok pabut, okaleutikut lu, okalubio tayu yoktam na hotline, nuwang na yualarin ng motoka ngayok, atuin na kuigiat kanilok pugut, tabu na ikayok na kang na atuni pilereyinik, ammalu, at natay dititsiku pilereyi, ahingit nut. Pilere kanut, nutiga kemagaptigu, tamakwa kawi hang need, pilere ayo kanak na tuluang na mata kingup mut, tuk yakhiyut, ammalu, nuwang na yualit, kanuin ningita mikanut, kawi hak tiu taktut, tamakwa mikanut. Tamakwa aheng ngotiri niulautut, hak kitara kalau raptigu, atau tikut, nuwang na yualire ni luksuta lu, ahingit nitao atwin no gyakak tunik antnak teliu atwin no yakak tunik antnak teliti chiku iluanik tamakuning atao atau chiku pilareni lukapta nuwang nalwa kihimi pilare kadungit man pilare katigi tuluk tango bugut nuwang nalwa me ungatak tisuta Mat nawa kay bunga nunavum mutanik ikayong nakalwa kemagap hitaw kaya hung naugalwang ninganik kikang naugalwang ninganik nunavum mut inuokatimitnik ihumagiya katsiyakutik katya kalaw ngitut iglolwang muta ko katigig ngitang minik nire katya kang nilaw tugaluit kihini nire katya kako unilaw kemayut Ammalu makanunali ahingit nut aulang ni lau kemayut ahengok teri lau kemayut ammalu kapiyau lau kemayut kemani kapiyau nikut kubehung nau ninganik immaka inutu bluni temakua mikiyu yak tu galuit kihieni katiluk ta sugit temakua nunavum miut pilereni rehima yangit nuwang naljuak mikanut katiluk ta sugit angiyu mata ilagi jabut ilag katangotigi jabut kanigi jabut amalu nunaligi jabut ulore nak tumi khonagit taima tening ni ala kalwa sungalu tamakwa atulak titau himayut ati malit charlak put kapiyau ni luk takta atuin nak takalangat nunalil ahingit nut Aula telit takta, aula reakangit tarangapta, ammalu ip yakotinik, matuanik, atuin nau yakakta luta, kanigia karakarangapta, ati tapkua pilere niit, atuin narak lavut, ulurenang inna kamihok tuluang narapta, ammalu nuwang naru, hakit tang nereyangit, nunaliptitnik, tilammiu nakau nakmata, anigoktit tuluang naraptigu kaninakakut, Ammalu ukua atulak titau himayut iswa kayak juamut kelam miu nak hakut kanin nak hakut atukun ne atulua ne agaptigu mat nak himat lagi tunga at ne ateli titci kut nut pilere jigi yap titnu ilak ammalu nunavum miu tanut pilere katigi tuluk tangu himagapta hanat teli agau hang ni makong ne kangik himayunik akorong nak tut hakitak himagaluak titsugit Piuna kamu toa tamana ati aulare kanak tahibuk mut pilih katigi tuin nau yakta matna. To begin, I know many in Iqaluit are wondering about the elders facility after six staff members were identified through contact tracing and diagnosed with COVID-19. None of the elders at the facility have been identified as high-risk contacts, nor have any tested positive for COVID-19. We have a number of casual staff who cover shifts at the elders' home in Iqaluit, and staffing levels remain stable. It is also an assisted living facility, which means the clients are relatively independent and require less direct staff interaction and support. Looking at the past 2 weeks, I have to offer a huge matna, koyunnamik, and koana to our Nunavut health staff. You've faced a massive workload and many other challenges, but you have all done us proud. Our nurses and lab staff have been working around the clock on COVID testing, analyzing results, and contact tracing to track and contain the virus. Our support staff have also played an important role in our response to date. Omicron spread in our communities and the rapid rise we brought on additional support services and adjusted protocols. We added virtual support for the hotline and contact tracing. We also redeployed allied health staff to support case monitoring. These actions were needed for health to continue delivering an effective COVID response while still offering other essential health services. We're all in this together. I want to thank all the Nunavummiut who have also helped to fight COVID over the holiday period. Those considerate, caring people who didn't gather indoors, who canceled their dinners and travel plans, and got vaccinated over the holiday period. It may feel small, but each single action that we take against COVID is important in protecting our families, friends, and communities. By following public health measures, by getting vaccinated, by avoiding non-essential travel, and by wearing a mask, we can all take action to reduce our COVID-19 risks, reduce the length of outbreaks in our communities, and reduce the need for strict public health restrictions. I truly appreciate the efforts health staff and so many Nunavummiut have made in working together during the past 2 weeks. Despite our difficulties, we are headed in the right direction. So please, let's keep going. Matna.
I'm grateful for the opportunity to address you this morning. I understand the concerns that families, school staff, and communities have around keeping our learners healthy and safe as we begin to reopen schools and childcare facilities. I share those concerns, and since this pandemic began, my department made health and safety of our students its highest priority. We must balance the risk of transmission of COVID-19 with the harms of extended school closures. While we know the current COVID-19 environment is particularly concerning, my department is working closely with the Chief Public Health Officer, CPHO, to ensure students and staff can return to school safely when the time is right.
Happy to help to tell you, Nagamo, Halimaka, Nalasa,
Unless directed otherwise by the CPHO, we're expecting school staff to be able to return to school on January 17th to provide remote instruction and prepare for the return of students on January 24th. Whether it's provided through our online platform EdSby or through take-home learning packages, remote instruction beginning on January 17th will be assessed and will count towards the final grades. It's important to remember the situation of COVID could change at any time based on the direction of the CPHO. Due to rapidly increasing cases of COVID-19 in our territory, the CPHO will provide further guidance later this week on the exact dates of school reopenings by community. While the circumstances are quickly changing, we have dealt with these challenges before. We know what to do and how to learn together. We have proven that we know how to care for each other. Schools will continue to be guided by the documents that were provided at the beginning of the school year, as well as their own experience from previous school closures. In light of the current COVID-19 situation, additional health and safety guidelines have been shared with schools. Schools have also been provided with large volumes of disposable medical grade child and adult masks. Anak bimatok tawag na sunik sukusak nut innak nudlo matuani.
Ilinabilimavut. Where did you go to? Okay, yeah, go ahead.
All of our schools have established processes to safely deliver learning packages and or devices for remote learning. Devices purchased by my department last year remained in the high schools and are ready to be distributed. My team has been working to diligently to go. Every community in the territory has received some devices to support remote learning, and schools have been given the flexibility to distribute devices where they will be most useful.
Harisau ya kala ni wakta si mayot pili riving anu aka ni ulau tuk suli ilin ni abe alum ni tut atu ina ulak tut iktu ni kakta ugun nam ni in. Takwa pili ri khatigi at suru tuk has si mayot takwa harisau ya kala ikita ugun na khullugit atu ina ugun na khullugin lo. Minalili mani, nuna bumi, kisimalik tutamakku ni nga harisau ya kala ni angik kami ni ilin ni arun nautinik. Ilin na bilo tako asin si hatak tu siyo tayo gumnak tu hanok tu niya kaya hatang na mga tahari sa uya kalanin at uti hanok pa ko hawi ka sa hatak luti.
January diploma exams for Nunavut students have been cancelled due to the evolving COVID-19 situation across our territory. This decision applies to only the January 2022 exams. Decisions around the April and June diploma exams will be made at a later date. Students who were scheduled to write a diploma exam in January 2022 will receive an exemption, and their school mark will stand for 100% of their overall mark. Students and families should contact their school with any questions.
January me tako ilin na belum me kau isak tau gupti uyut exams guna kau tau uyut nuna bumi ilin na ati nuk kapti tau semalik tu taman nuna kau 19 pijut igi lugu nuna bumi tan nai semalik aku tau semayok tako January 2022 nuk kau isak uti tau lau tu galuanu semalik aku tau lau ningit April me June bilu kau isak tau gupti tau lau tu nik tako nalu nai tau lau tu ubat siarukannya. Ilin natin tayo at tira kaya halang alaw to ilin na bayalo mi kaya sa tayo guti ni January 2022 mi tayo kanuit kuya na tayo sa maguti kakay ng nato tayo ilin na bimi nalunay ko tangita kanuti ilin na tigis sa mga 100% ngunit ka tayo luti tayo nalunay ko tayo guti ngita ilin na palianingin no. Ilin na tit ilagi ilo kaya kay gali kaya gali ilin na bimi no apakotit sa katwa kutin.
Last week, Premier Akeeagok and I asked child care facilities to reopen to help critical industry workers who are in desperate need of child care. I would like to thank those facilities who have reached out to my department and have reopened and are accepting children. We understand that there is some fear and concern about the safety of staff and children should facilities reopen. My department will work with facilities to provide support around health and safety and be able to answer questions that they may have. As a way to recognize child care facilities willing to reopen, my department is exploring the possibility of monetary incentives for the facilities and their staff. We know that without your support, our critical services are critically threatened.
Tumi sibulok ta kharlo kay ma perila ugata pai rebi matu ta kan ni hun gurna khullu gita ko ekhana ya ga khallagittu ta ko pai ge kha ga khallagin ni no pijuti gillu gi khana ya kan ni gurna khullu gi ta ko khoyan na mi ta ka pai rebi ta ko kha ga lo pili rebi ti no matu kan ni simalak sutillo takwalo bayri bi moti chatarunna lersutillo tuki siyo magalo atunga kapya sunningin nik isumalun ningin nillo takolo rena pemitri na hanningin ne khana yati tsurusillo bayri bi matikannam nakata pilri vitinni pilri khate khamne atul bayri binni ekayosu ilutik tamatumunga khanoi teilitit sinang mulo rena pemitelitit sinang mulo kiu khatarunna lutillo apekuti sakato akata Tema ilu sa iyo kung nahulugi pa iribi, matuikan ni Simayuit, pilaribit din ni Kawiya sa kpalli ayo, takwa kinaw yan ni Kakan ni Ngagwi, kayo sa atatit si Katar, gumna ni Kmul pa iribin ni Ikanayak tingin nulo. Kawiya mayugo takwa, ikayong ikutsi, matuing ang ikutsi, takwa piyit si Rauti, matuing ang iyakala rito, tema ulugan at tumili kayang ata, nukhaktitaw tuin na iyakaluti.
For Nunavut post-secondary students, I'm pleased to share that COVID-19 has not caused any delays in financial assistance for Nunavut students, FANS, benefits, and the FANS January payments to students have been issued as scheduled. Although response times from the FANS office may be delayed due to active COVID-19 cases in Iqaluit, FANS payments are not delayed. Any FANS students who have questions about their payments should contact FANS office at fans@gov.nu.ca. In closing, I would like to ask all of you to please do whatever you can to support your students and your schools. We need all Nunavummiut to help our students go back to school safely by getting vaccinated, staying home when they're sick, and following the health guidelines.
Nunavummi sila tusabin ni ilin ni atinut huwiatong ahon na kamataman na nuwadyoanak 19 kinubari ati sigutaw sing mangimat ilin ni atinut kino yakti ko ikayuti ni Nunavummi ammalutako ilin ni atinut kino yakti ko ikayuti January miyakiligutaw loktut ilin ni atinut tema tuniyaus malakto Takwa kiu hatam ningi fans ku Allah binga ni kingo baksi majut sa tu na halu ati lugi nu bajua na 19 ham ninga nu abdiani takwa fans ku akili uta yu kingo ba yakta ujang itu takwa fans ku tigo ilin ne ati yu ika yu sa ta patu abe kuti sa katu akata akili ta ugu tingin ni takwa hau yige agun na tu hari sa yakku fans@gov.nu.ca Piyari rutigi lugu, tayo mapiri in narivatsi tay ma hanuilu hanutuin nak ikayo kasuarun na hullu se ilin na titinut ilin na bisin nillo nuna bumi limat ikayo wa hangata ilin na bitinik ilin na rakan na run na hullu gi attanang itukut kapiyaw simalutillo ang kasima hatarlutillo hani mato aray gutik mali hatarlutillo ana hamnang itulerin mo malita kuyaw simayuni kuana
Hi, Kent Driscoll, ABTN National News. Mr. Gross, in your remarks there, you mentioned about the learning packages and how this time they are going to be assessed and used for the final mark. That hasn't happened in the previous lockdowns. I was wondering if you could explain how that process is going to work and whether it's going to be for all grades. Sort of take me through the correction of these packages, please.
ETN kun ne hakha ga vita ko elin ne abim me ila elin ne rutu ne ato ang ka jo hatta ne ato nalu ne ato hatta ne ang ate ila gilu jo lu tiking ul pa si mo khanu ti elin ne pa le ani ta nalu nai kutang in nu te me hatta yung im ma ta man nalu nai ga la ro khanu kama ga yau na manga
Kwana for your question my department in collaboration with the CPHO and Our education partners released a new series of documents to support schools for the 2021-2022 school year. And over the last several months, these schools have been using documents wherever they need to bring instruction to the during the pandemic. And in this case, the school documents our guiding forms of instruction for assessment. And right now, there's different ways that the schools are going to be phased in, and it depends on the school and where they're going, where they sit, I guess, in terms of if there's COVID in the community or not. So based on each school, they'll be assessed in different ways depending on if they're at home learning or learning in the school.
Thank you. And Minister Gross, I'm wondering then, in the previous lockdowns and the previous school closures, the teachers weren't able to correct those packages. What has changed now that's going to allow for teachers to correct and grade those packages?
Minister Gross, takwa ilu matu semahat tilugi nunavu amalu ilu nabit ilu nabit siji takwa ilu nabu timinam ni kawiga hatagun na yung imata kisumila si jakto hanga takwa kawis saktagun na hatam na ilu kailu nabu tiyubalayo.
Kwana, for the question. In some cases, we have learnt a lot from the past, and we have approved the phased-in approach and the reopening of the schools based on community given from the direction of the CPHO.
Teresa Hetchuk, CBC News. Pamela Gross, summa kingovak simani rengi pe fans kino zani atu ino hatakti chizo e ilin niakti no January bigar palia di logo apiri hatala urtu ini kine pigumani raksuti fans kuno tunizawala ungin matakina uzangi ni Pamela Gross, why are you saying fans' payments aren't delayed when students in Iqaluit had to ask for food at the beginning of the month because of their payments were delayed?
Kwana, for the question. Right now, COVID-19 has not caused any delays in fans. Due to the GN office closures in Iqaluit and the impacts of COVID-19 in the community, we have some delays to people who have not completed their enrollment forms, and the enrollment forms are what processes their application to get paid. So in certain cases, some students were affected if they did not complete their enrollment form.
Okay, this question might be for Patterson or Akeeagok. Pival lea zule riziko Globe and Mail. Nada unai xila uktoi dali mai hausi sak vimi pili rizi anya vimi. Nokar nirmata November me amma December me. Taman nasuliva. The Globe and Mail reported that 5 lab technicians quit from the hospital in November and December. Can you confirm this?
They don't work in the health protection or work for the CPHO, but through personal knowledge, I can confirm, yeah, that 5 lab techs resigned from Iqaluit in the end of November, early December.
November nungwani December pigyang ningani
how many lab technicians are working now?
I don't know the exact number, but we've only been able to Kikiktani General Hospital has only been able to hire 1 since then.
Thank you.
Emma Tranter, the Canadian Press. To follow up on Teresa's questions, why did those lab technicians resign and did that have any effect on our testing capability here?
Emma Tranter, Canadian Press,
thanks for the question. As it's a HR matter, I can't get into too much detail in terms of why the staff resigned, but I can say that our capacity in terms of lab technicians is a major issue in terms of how we can respond to COVID. We are very appreciative of the staff members who are still with the department, and there are 2 lab techs here in Iqaluit still with the department. We've been attempting to hire more, but things are very tight nationally in terms of that very specialized skill set, and that is precisely why Premier Akeeagok reached out to the federal government and asking for human resource assistance, in that if we have more lab technicians, among other positions, we'll be in a much stronger position to respond to outbreaks. So okay, try and remember what I said now. Pidju hirsutik nokkalok mga ta okaw hari yulungit taka kang munak tu takak nakakak mat taman na pidju tigit sugu kihene okak tu ulak tunga pilagay yukat siyangin nga yabut uwani kaw yukak tu lagay nang mo pilagay yuyut lab technicians taman na tulok tako tau himal lakito nubang na uwang may ungatak niluk tisuta maani takkang nakang kima yunik pilagayik kanyang ni huli kinagalwak pugut ukuinga galwak pugut pilagayik kanyang ni nanihini luksuta kihiani amiga kilagik matatama kwa kawi hak tulagay ng mo pilagayik lab technicians Canada o iluani taman na tulok tako tau lagik tok pidutigisuta ba ilanga rana hibulak tigiyabut titikala ok mabo government to kakunut ikayok ta huwak suta pilagay yita kanak titaw yu luangit mga apta pilagay law kaktu luang na aktunik kawi haktu lagay ni umikanut nubang na luang nubang na yu mikanut pilagay kanaka la
Pigukan Nara Yaraluarap, the Hanging Nakauna Yaraluarap, the Gavoma Bluta, Pilere Yakaka Nerupta, Atwin Nakaka Narayan Napan.
Thank you. I think my next question is for Dr. Patterson. Sorry, I thought I had one more. Okay, it's a quick one. I'm just wondering, we've seen a drop in cases over the last few days. Does that coincide at all with the testing changes that we've seen?
Hi, some got the taco, Hachi, Napole, Nino, Ulugala, Simayonitaco, Hoy, Sakta, Hatting, Nino, the Mapijutaka.
A little bit, and it also coincides with, or it's also the sudden drop is caused by being able to clear the backlog of reporting the recovery of a number of cases. We were able to audit those numbers over the weekend and confirm that there were a number of people who had been cleared from isolation at the community level, like they stopped their isolation on or close to the appropriate day, but it hadn't been reported to the epidemiologist at that point.
Ilanga go takwata hatse nauka la palila o tuka ko ame suile palila la ni no hanu igu ti khak hanu igu ne igu ti khak palila ne khak ta osi mayut pina sa go si unu ngani na sak ta utsa la nga ta ta ko ani teile khu ya go ne te nu na le ni na sak ta una sa to minu hat ta ni la nga ta ta ko hatse na go palila sa mayut ta ko sa ma palila yo le ri ku nu na sak ta yu.
Trevor Wright, Nunavut News. Do community health centers have enough testing kits to report new cases or new community transmission, new community introductions?
Trevor Wright, Nunavut News.
Yes, and we have more in reserve here in our warehouses in Rankin Inlet and Iqaluit that could be shipped if needed.
Got another question related to testing. What does the current COVID-19 case count now represent now that we've changed our protocols?
Like everywhere else, it's an incomplete picture of what's going on.
This question is from Don Alec from Kugak Radio. It's for the Premier. She just wants some clarification because people are being asked not to call to go to the health center. So, and in terms of that, how are people who have to isolate but are not COVID positive, able to access isolation support kits?
Thank you for the very good question. Right now,
There's obviously a process in place to be able to access the hamper program under our secretariat. And that is relied upon in terms of the healthcare professionals. So with that, obviously the phone call is what's required for this particular request to come. But we've been working very effectively with our partners as well. So with the Inuit organizations, the multiple levels there, the regional Inuit associations have been exceptional in terms of providing the support as well, in terms of combating food insecurity, as well as our partners with NTI. So there's multiple levels of food insecurity programs through the food hampers that we deliver. However, with the program through EIA, it is through the recommendation of the public health official where we provide assistance for members for Nunavut to access the program. So, Huyanamim.
I have a number of questions for Minister Gross. The first question is from David Venn from Nunatak News. How many laptops does the GN have in storage ready to be sent out to communicate for separate, for remote learning? And how will these be prioritized if there are not enough for each student who will be learning remotely?
David News
Quanta for the question. Currently, my department has 5,000 internet-ready digital devices for schools, should in-school instruction be restricted. There have been over 3,700 digital devices that have been distributed to communities, and every community has received some devices.
3,700.
We have received 1.5 million in funding from NTI to purchase additional 600 internet-ready devices to support schools. By region, as of this month, January 2022, in the Iqaluit, there are 536 devices in the schools and 320 en route, a total of
856.
For the Kivalik, there are 1,181 devices, and on order there are 600 for a total of 1,761 devices. Currently, the Kikikdani has 1,672 devices and 1,000 on order for a total of 2,672 devices.
Kikikdani, 1,672. 1,000 tikizahayao simaluti katilugi 2,672.
The remaining 1,300 devices have been purchased but have not been received due to the global supply chain. These devices were intended to support high school students and their teachers. However, schools have the flexibility to identify students or grades where there's a need and distribute accordingly. Unfortunately, unavoidable internet and bandwidth issues in some communities may affect the use of devices.
1300 new victims in my youth, Sani Pisimangita, Nunabja, Miamiga, Sani Kungino, Tamakuminga, and Ilina Velo, Milinair to eat, Ilinair to Chilling Illu, Nalunair Seratau, Narnair to Ilinair to Nick, Nalia Pititao Hatan Narmangata.
This is the follow-up to the question from David Venn again, Nunatsiak News. Last year, we heard about students not having equal access to technology and internet, experiencing food insecurity at home, having to help care for siblings or sick family members, and having unsafe home lives affecting their learning. Is anything being done differently to try to address any of these issues?
Hold on. Takota, David, me apekutikani nuna chef news kunni tako ilinne ati kinuliolo ila matutse mahatta tillugu ilangi atu inna hahatta kunna laungi matatama kunenga ikia kivikku kunna utin ilinne arutit sauri jaktuni ilangi nirigat sahatse ahatta adik. Ilang ilo mi hati gilo ato mi sulo ato tik ilang ihani maya hatta sutik ato nato mi hatta suti ilang ihano ledi yung ito kuman na kamari yohan na kataman na aula ni hatta.
One for the follow-up question, and sorry, Uli. we understand the impact on learning for every family will be different. The teachers know their students and will provide instruction to support students regardless of their circumstances. While schools are closed, food programs cannot continue. However, we will work with schools to continue food programs safely once they're open. Many organizations have put food hamper programs in place for families affected by COVID-19.
Koyanami, Tako, Tokusio Magalo Atunga Tako, Ajigging it to Natuta Hatamangata, Ilagi, Nunalini, Ilinati, Lohoya Machangata, Ilinati Mini, Hano to Nakayaso Hatamna, Ilinati Mini, Ilinambi, Matamati Logitako, and Neritich Hatamu Matuina Yagunang in Mata, Matukan Kata, Pia Candila to Galoat, Sani Amisu Timu, Yukayo Hati, Hatangata, Tako, and Neriatsani, Payutu Hatatati.
Kent Driscoll, APTN National News. Minister Gross, since your comments earlier today, I've received a number of notes from parents and teachers wondering about the specifics of your plan. From January 17th, going forward, can you please lay out specifically when students are coming back, when packages are going out? Can you please get into as much detail as possible about the plan?
Minister Gross, Dako Amisunik, Apikutu Halangangi Yokaria Unik, Dako January 17, Mipigia Lugunaluna Yaki, Nala Hanuling Alari Namangata, Ilin Nerti, Hanok Nuri Vijaham Nam Namangata, Pelani.
Kwana, for your question, right now there are going to be different details depending on the schools. However, right now, we must balance the risk of transmission of COVID-19 with the harms extended of the school closures. So right now, we're working on various ways to ensure that the schools either can open or close. And for each school, it's different based on their situation, if there's COVID-19 in their community or not. And right now, the schools are on a phased approach, and that has been the direction and approval by the CPHO. So it depends on what area each community is in, depending on the situation of COVID-19. And each school will communicate that information to the parents and the students.
Kuyan na meek man na yung tako at jiging ito katalang ang mga tayla ilin na abin ni tako na limugitit siya kakataulo kaya na tumitailitit sinang muno ba niya na maintain takatil lugan malo ilin na abin matuyaw si maning ulo kaya na tumigutaw mata at jiging ito ni tako ilin na abin matui kalle yau ne atu balu matu matui na hatang ne atu atu ni nuwa jua nak tu ham mga tamalit tau lutik tak ilangi asid jo kalle yau hatang ne atu hanu matui kalle ne am ningi tak malit tau lutik ana ham ningi tulir yang mariu kili yau si matu tingit atu ni lunu na bumi nuna li nuwa jua nak tu hangin ningi tak jige hatta jangin mata tak walau atu ni ilin ne abe tu sakit si hatang ne atu ngayok kari yau yunu hanu ilang alak mga ata ilin ne abe ni.
Teresa Hachuk, CBC News. My question is for John Main. Minister Main, ukhakatak tuti ilagyak sinikak suti kazuti ni anya hak nangitulirinir mo ukhakunak hitako hanuitu mangata. Minister Main, you said you brought on additional support to bolster health staff. What additional support did you add?
Well, there's a number of different measures that have been put in place. I'll talk about, I guess, the hotline service. We've brought on additional staff to support the hotline. We're aware that there were Nunavut who were experiencing long wait times on that hotline, and in response to that, the clear need that Nunavut had, we've been able to bring on additional virtual public health staff. And so when we say virtual, they are actual people, but they are not in the necessarily in the community of the person that they're helping. So long distance assistance and guidance in terms of isolation, in terms of managing people who are positive. So that's one thing that's happened in terms of the hotline. And we've also had internally, we've been able to redeploy some people or shift some staff over to focus on the COVID response. So in a general sense, a lot of the barriers that we're facing or a lot of the bottlenecks are related to human resources, and I have to go back to that request that our premier put into the federal authorities, where we are in bad need of assistance on the human resource front to respond to COVID-19, and that is our key bottleneck right now in terms of doing more. So thank you.
Ajiing itu nih kanu ilio tio jo nih akhir cuci sama juga untuk aku pelu waktu meu kalau beu hatta tu ngasih tu mea ke hang itu tak aku kena yang kita akan nih sama yuk nuna bum meu aku nih tak sehat tali langga tau kalau gas waktu tan nalu nih tau saya langga tak aku ikan yuk tak akan nih hang dingin nih amalu kena yang kita akan nih sama juga hari saya yuk ikan yuk nak tu nih tak aku ikan yang tidak tanggung kalau aku saya nih ngasih tu meu tu hari saya yuk ikan yuk tu. Taman naul atau guna hulu guna wajah anak 19 tak perlu anak amal utak ku pilih betul ni asing ini kena yang ini nutik sejak semua juga tak ku wajah anak 19 mereka mabal lihat hulu tak ku abah aku tiup napa aku kena yang tiket sambil tak ku tanya mai mau house ini usah tu nak tak sih boleh tiap tu cerakan ni lau ni anu gawat matu hakun ni tak ku kena yang tak ku nak halal ini tinu wajah anak 19 lagi hulu tak.
Emma Trancher, the Canadian Press. I'm wondering, Minister Main, if you can give us an update on the elders at Embassy West. How are they doing? Do they have symptoms? I feel like we haven't heard enough about how those folks are doing down there.
Emma Trancher, Canadian Press. Minister Main,
Matna perigabit I tako tauna ni Embassy West in no hibiga ni hiltut nunavum miut tu hakema yakku tu kihiuma yakku kanuitu kalua kemangitu galua nuwang nalua ta kema yut inu tokait pingahuni akwini dit 8 ngohima yut
manamut kihen ilangat mamin nerakto himalikhluni recovered kihen akor nachtu me hertu inuto qaida wa ni hertu nalunangito pilere ikkanermik teikunga pilere yartornertu mi haqqi himayugut amma ikayutik kanerni haqqi ni luk himayugut ilagiyarminut toraangayunik qawi hain noyar nagar putamanna atulaorninganik ammalu qanuito qaqunnangillarik mat ikayutik kanerni haqqi yuulluarne upta haqqi nerruta
Thank you for the question. The Embassy West facility, the outbreak is obviously a big concern to our department. To date, we've had 8 residents that have been infected with COVID. However, one of them is now considered recovered. So there's 7 currently. We have been monitoring the situation closely. We've put in place an additional staff member on site to assist during this especially stressful period. We've also put in place supports for families, trying to encourage essential caregivers to go down to Embassy West and assist with care and to help out where they can with their elders. So it's a situation that we're monitoring very closely, and we are continuing to look for ways that we can help the residents and their families.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Trevor Wright, Nunavut News. A couple of questions for Dr. Patterson. Have public health measures caught up with the spread in this outbreak so far?
Trevor Wright, Nunavut News, Kumnitakoana, Hamanito Lerano, Mamalito, Kuyosimayo, Angombatisima Vamana, Samapalia, New Yumo.
I'm not sure what you mean. We continue to see evidence of community transmission, and we continue to see multiple introductions in a few communities.
We
have seen that the average number of contacts in at least some communities has declined over the last week, so that's encouraging. But other than that, it's a difficult question
to comment on.
How has Omicron changed Nunavut's path, or how has that, how has that changed Nunavut's path, like as it was before?
It's one of the most infectious agents that we know of right now, or that's known. And so the approach in the last, since Omicron developed, has really been change to one of reducing the risk as much as possible and protecting those who are most vulnerable and the critical services.
Thank you so much for joining us. That's the end of our press conference for today. We'll have another one on Thursday at 11 a.m. And we'll keep you updated on social media and through the GN website with any other news that we have between now and then.
Hoi nami, taima. Sita me pigea kanila ku ilapa.